Hello, my name is Meryl and I'll be talking about what the interviewee told about subjective well-being. So according to the interviewee, subjective well-being involves having sympathy for the other person to understand that the other person is in a lot of pain. When you empathize with others, what actually happens is you'll be in a better position to relate to your own stress. Now, this is something which has been validated by research studies. So it has been found that people who indulge in a lot of emotional self-regulation are in a better position to relate with others. They are in a better position to engage in interpersonal communication. So it is really important that you also invest in physical support. Maybe you could be getting physical support from your friends, family members, relatives, or even pets. You could even go for emotional support from these people. Lastly, you need to also spend some time getting spiritual support. What that means is you need to engage in maybe some prayer groups or Bible studies. And another piece of advice which ma'am gave for the caretakers was that you need to take breaks in between. It is essential that you look after yourself and engage in self-care activities. Because when anxiety strikes, it is important that you analyze the situation instead of reacting to it in the very first go. It is important to respond to the situation instead of reacting to it. And when ma'am was asked what she did when she felt lonely, she said, it is important that you do not revel in that moment of loneliness. You should not let it linger in your existence. You need to get out of it. Maybe you could ask one of your friends to take you out for a walk, or maybe you could engage in some sort of spiritual connect with the Almighty. Anything works. But for ma'am, it was her connect with Christ. She said that is the key to not feeling lonely at all. Even when there is no human connect, you can always form a connect with the Almighty. Now, I'll be talking about what does spirituality mean from a positive psychology point of view.